What is neodymium? Neodymium is a rare earth metal and the strongest permanent magnet material yet discovered. Magnets might just seem useless and maybe just handy for sticking reminders on fridges. However, the neodymium iron boron magnet market was worth $11.3 billion in 2017. So what is neodymium used for? Well, just about most electronic devices in green tech, like solar panels, wind turbines, electric vehicles, contain some amount of neodymium or other rare earth metals. Take a Tesla, for example. As an electric vehicle, Teslas are supposed to be environmentally friendly, emitting less greenhouse gases and air pollutants over their life. Specifically, the Tesla Model 3 comes supported by a neodymium-intensive permanent magnet motor, a stronger magnet making for higher energy efficiency. Despite neodymium's versatility and use in green energy materials, rare earth metals come with a price. Removal of these materials from the Earth's crust using a mix of water and chemicals causes extensive water and soil pollution, thus creating stockpiles of acidic lakes filled with radioactive material. Because most countries are hesitant to deal with this problem, China's taken up rare earth metals in full force. China's role in the industry cannot be discounted, producing more than 80% of the world's neodymium, most of which comes from one city. In fact, half of China's total rare earth metal extractions come from Baotou. Radioactive materials often lace rare earth metal ores, and refining requires huge amounts of carcinogenic toxins. Processing one ton of rare earths produces 2,000 tons of toxic waste. Baotou's rare earth enterprises produce 10 million tons of wastewater per year. As one BBC reporter who visited put it, dozens of pipelines lined the shore, churning out a torrent of thick, black chemical waste from the refineries that surround the lake. The smell of sulfur and the roar of pipes invades my senses. It feels like a hell on earth. In China's eyes, Baotou, however, is the perfect location for rare earth mining. The city is located deep within Mongolia, north of Beijing, far away from the eastern coast, where most of the population and financial centers reside. While the demand for electric cars, supercomputers, and alternative green energy sources skyrocket, so rises the world's demand for neodymium. Despite China acknowledging the detriments of rare earth mining, China continues to dominate the market and mine for neodymium, furthering the demise of Baotou. Chinese health officials report illnesses from locals who are suddenly experiencing nausea and dizzy spells, arthritis and migraines when they drink the water. Livestock have died en masse, and some of the radioactive materials found in the mud have been linked to increased risks of several types of cancer, including leukemia. The dynamic between China and rare earth mining in Baotou mirrors how other powers have risen throughout history. Think of the environmental issues Britain had faced with its coal obsession, and the issues Brazil faces with lumber. Perhaps the rise of a quickly growing global power and the ensuing popularity of the power's commodity comes with an inevitable environmental cost.